Good morning. I welcome you all to the series of lectures on compressors. Today we are going to derive the indicated compressor work input with the clearance volume. See what happens if clearance volume is there, that we have to focus first. The work done on the air in the clearance space during compression. You know, for example, if you consider the piston cylinder arrangement, this is the top dead center TDC. Even the piston reaches to TDC, some amount of volume is present at the top of the piston, that is called clearance volume. So if I compress the air and it will deliver, if clearance volume is present, some amount of air remains inside the clearance volume and it will affect the next coming suction stroke, because this air will expand first, then the further upcoming air will enter. So that means it will affect the suction capacity of the cylinder. So that means the work done on the air in clearance space during compression. So during compression, the work done on the air in the clearance space is almost equal to the work done by air when it re-expands during suction. During suction, the air which is the compressed air which is available in the clearance volume is first re-expand. So that means re-expand means it is doing some work on the piston. So that work is equal to work done by the air on the piston is equal to work done on the air during compression. The work done on the air in the clearance space during compression is equal to work done by air when it is re-expands during suction. So that means there is no change in negative work. There is no change in work input when we place clearance volume. That is the statement here. Hence the work on compression is not affected by clearance volume. But the mass of air inducted is reduced. But the mass of air induced is reduced. And thus volumetric efficiency of the compressor will be less. The volumetric efficiency of the compressor is less. Let us see the working of a compressor with clearance volume on a PV plot. Let us represent the working of a compressor with clearance volume on a PV plot. This is the PV. 1 to 2 is the compression. 2 to 3 is the delivery. 2 to 3 is the delivery. After delivery, some amount of air remains in the clearance volume that will expand. So that means this is the expansion. Expansion follows up to 4. After 4, the pressure is P1. So that means it is a suction. This is suction. Suction, compression, delivery, expansion. And suction again. So actually, if clearance volume is not there after delivery, the pressure suddenly falls to here and suction begins from here. So this is the diagram. If clearance volume is not there, this is the diagram. The delivery occurred up to here. After that, if there is no air inside the cylinder, the pressure falls to P1 and suction happens from here. So the effective swept volume is V1 if clearance volume is not there. If clearance volume is there, the effective swept volume is after expansion. So this is the effective swept volume. Effective swept volume is V1 minus V4. And piston displacement volume is, this is the clearance volume. I may mention it is somewhat more. This is clearance volume. So this is the clearance volume. But the swept volume is piston displacement. That means top dead center to bottom dead center. V1 minus V3. This much is the piston displacement. Out of that, effective swept volume is only this much. Because this much is not there. This much volume is not there. Because the gas is, air is expanding. Right. So total volume is V1. This is the V1. Okay. Now we see if clearance volume is provided, the walls are easily actuated. So that's why we need to provide the clearance volume. But it should be less. Okay. Now we need to derive the work input for the compressor for if we provide clearance volume. See, the indicated work done is given by the area. The indicated work done for the compressor is given by the area 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 is the indicated work done on a PV curve. So indicated work is equal to area 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. This is the area that I want to calculate. So that area is equal to area 1, 2, ED. 1, 2, ED, 1. This is the area minus this is the area minus this area. This area minus this area gives the this loop area, right? Minus area 3ED4. 3ED4, this is the area. So first I need to calculate this area, then I will subtract this one, then I will get this one here. So area 1 to ED, 1 to ED, this is the area. Is a compression work. This area is the compression work actually. Okay, compression area. So which follows the PV power N C is equal to constant. N C is the compression index. PV power N E is equal to constant, this one. N E is the expansion index. So then compression work is equal to, already we derived N by N minus 1, P1 V1, P2 by P1, all power N minus 1 by N minus 1. But it is following compression with compression index N C. So I write N C in place of N. Then area 3E D4 is the expansion work with index NE, can also be written as N by N minus 1 P4 V4. Here the pressure is P4 V4. Earlier the pressure is P1 V1, initial point. P4 V4 into P3 by P4 all power NE minus NE, NE minus 1 by NE minus 1. NE means expansion index. Here N, in place of N we are writing NE. So here many students getting doubt, P2 by P1, that means final point by initial point here. Here P3 by P4, initial point by final point. Actually this is the formula, but this formula has written because it is a compression work, negative work. So in order to replace the negative, that's why we write P2 by P1. Okay. I mean, you are considering the magnitude, not the sign, okay? Then, if this is the compression work and this is the expansion work, so that means I need to subtract these two areas, then I will get indicated work. Indicated work 1, 2, 3, 4, E. So that is a net work compression. This indicated work is equal to this area, area 1, 2, ED. Area 1, 2, ED means NC by NC minus 1, this one. Minus area 3ED4, area 3ED4 means this one, minus NE by NE minus 1, P1, V4. Here, P4 is nothing but P1, P4 is both equal, P4 and P1 both are equal, P1, V4 into P2 by P1. Here, P3 means P2, P3 is equal to P2, P4 is equal to P1. So, P2 by P1 all power NE minus N by, NE minus 1 by NE minus 1. If indices are same, for example, if both compression and expansion follows the same index, NC is equal to NE is equal to N, if NC is equal to NE is equal to N, if compression, see, area, this area, I'm sorry, this area minus area 1 to ED, this one, minus area 3 ED4, this one. Okay, so here W in is the indicated work input, total indicated work input is equal to area this minus this one. This is minus this one I have written. Then if indices are same, NE, NC is equal to NE is equal to compression index is equal to expansion index is equal to N, then I can write, see, N by N minus 1. You can take N by N minus 1 as common into P1 as common. P1 here, P1 here common. V1 minus V4 multiplied by here. P2 by P1 all power N minus 1 by N. Here also P2 by P1 all power N minus 1 by N. So taken out common. Minus 1 minus 1. Actually it is minus 1. Okay. And if clearance volume is 0, the effective swept volume becomes V1. If the effective swept volume is become V1, this is the formula. Okay. That means in place of effective swept volume means don't compare here. Effective swept volume become V1 minus, actually it is effective swept volume means V1 minus V4. You may think that V1 minus V3. But it is wrong, it is V1 only. Because there is no clearance volume means automatically the air, there is no air present after clearance. There is no air present in the clearance volume, there is no expansion, so the gas will follow like this. After fully discharge, there is no air. After fully discharge, the pressure directly falls from this point, you will get this one. So this is the basic equation already we derived. Okay, thank you very much.